I was scared to death of roller coasters, and we moved to a new school when I was 15, and all the guys from the school, new friends, wanted to go to Six Flags. And I had a choice to make. I was gonna fit in or I was gonna be afraid. After the first roller coaster, I was hooked for life. I mean, there is some aviation in my family. My dad was a flight instructor. I worked at IBM and taught on the weekends. And my brother's an air traffic controller that has a license, but I was probably gonna be voted the least likely to ever get in an airplane and do this kind of stuff. So they still shake their head every time they see me, but you know, it was that one roller coaster ride at 15 years old that taught me, hey, don't be afraid. Just, you know, you're not gonna get hurt. Just attack fear head on, and I've done it ever since, and I try and encourage kids to do that. Well, I went in the Air Force. I was very lucky to get in the first place. I didn't do ROTC or Academy. I just went to school and then applied. I had my private pilot's license and went in and got selected to be a T-38 instructor at the end of training, and then went on to F-15Cs, and then taught the fighter leading course and finished out as a air liaison with the Army. Well, for the airlines, I fly 737. I've been typed in a 727. And then on the side, I've flown everything from, you know, Cessnas to Pitts's to Yaks to Extras, Rebels. But I always wanted to do an air show in a jet because that's kind of my lineage. That's what I love to do, and that's where I, you know, I feel comfortable the most. Been doing air shows. This is my second season. I just got my surface level waiver 2 weeks ago. And so this is my second surface level show, and having an absolute blast. I did fly competition. I flew most of it in a Christian Eagle. And then at the end, I had a Stoudacre that I flew some competition in. When I got to competition, I thought, wow, there's gonna be fighter pilots everywhere. And come to find out, most of the guys I were flying with was engineers, you know, airline pilots that never did military. All kinds of disciplines, but almost no fighter pilots. It was a slow progression. I thought I'd just kind of hop in and I got this. And the first time I did an Immelman, I ended up in a spin, and the instructor's laughing at me going, hey, you got a big prop out there that's turning. And I had to learn how to do everything I did in the Air Force, but now I had to learn how to do it with a gyroscopic engine and prop out in front. It was actually a humbling experience getting into like a Pitts or Christian Eagle. And then again, it was humbling to go over into a 500-pound jet and learn how to do what it likes to do, what it doesn't like to do, and put together a safe routine for the public. I saw the little James Bond jet in an air show when I was a kid, and I just thought that was the coolest thing in the universe. And I really thought, even though I've flown a MiG and I've flown other airplanes, one is the affordability, but two is this really connects with the kids. It's their size. And this, for me, is my chance to give back, to motivate kids, to speak to kids. The small jet is the tool to do it. Well, the Subsonics is a great little jet. It's got a great, very forgiving wing. It talks to you like a Piper Cub. It lands as slow as 60 and goes up to 300 miles an hour when I'm going down the show line. So it really is a wonderful flying little aircraft. I do a very gentleman-like aerobatic routine. But because of its size and the ability to corner it, you can keep it right in front of the crowd. It's just a great flying little vehicle, and better than that, it's great to relate to the public.